India, country with over 1.3 million schools imparting elementary education across 633 districts under one of the largest education initiatives in the world. Over 374 million, one third of the world's population under age 15, resides here. At first sight, it seems quite a pleasing condition, but sadly, the tool which is going to unleash this potential, education, is so boring here that over 60% of the children drop out at the primary level. Indeed, nearly 50% of the children drop out during the first 3 years because of poor quality of schooling, boring curriculum, and pressure of poverty. Despite the government's claim that 83% of all children attend school, reliable reports indicate that almost half of the children and some one-third of the teachers regularly fail to show up for classes. Most of the schools run in makeshift shelters without any facilities for drinking water and toilet. Is there any way out? Yes, there is. School Adoption Program. NGOs, universities, corporates, and other groups can adopt a malfunctioning school, and together with school, volunteers and governments try to make it a model school in 3 years. After adopting the school, a committee is made which constitutes of school management, representative from adopter, parents, local intellectuals. They decide the goals, and since the stakeholders are involved, the change will be sustainable. Infrastructure goals such as proper facilities for water, desks, toilets, computers, and library are achieved. But is it all? No. What matters the most is not the infrastructure but the pedagogy and teachers. To improve upon this, volunteers go to school regularly, organize events, extracurricular activities like sports, arts, and most importantly, activity-based learning in which students are totally involved. As said, tell me and I forget. Teach me and I remember. Involve me and I learn. This applies both for students as well as teachers. Looking at the progress made by children, increase in attendance and decrease in dropout rates as a result of methodology adopted by volunteers, teachers also start to get involved and learn the ways of keeping curiosity of children alive. Even after all these changes, how is the model school to be made sustainable? This is where parents and communities' involvement comes in. Because they are important stakeholders, because they are the Supreme Court of the locality, they are the ones living there and must be involved in the process via school committee, various events and meetings. Thus, the school becomes a model school where children come happily to learn and get truly educated, not merely literate.